My name is Max Clark, also known as Cutworms. Where am I from? Originally Cleveland, Ohio. And I'm now based in Brooklyn, New York.
And when did you start making music?
I've been making music, or trying to, since I was probably 12. Making my own songs are probably around 12.
Who did you listen to growing up?
Kind of whatever was on the radio. In Cleveland there was a lot of classic rock and oldies and stuff. So a lot of that.
And how did you get started?
I got a guitar from a garage sale my mom got me for like $5. It didn't have hardly any strings on it, and then fixed it up and sort of taught myself how to play. A couple of my uncles helped me. They played music, and then I just started trying to write songs and eventually started trying to play open mics and whatever I could do.
When do you feel you got your first break?
My first break? I guess there's a lot of first ones. You know, they kind of start off small and then they get bigger and bigger but it takes a long time. So I don't know. My first break might have been just having people in my life that got me interested in playing music in some way.
How did you decide that this is what you were going to do?
It's really the only thing that I am that passionate about that I'm not, or you know, care about enough to where doing it all the time doesn't feel like work. It's still work, but you know, to a certain extent it's kind of just what I've always wanted to do.
What life events do you feel have had a big impact on you and your music?
Life events? I guess going to school in Chicago, meeting a lot of people and musicians there, and kind of spending time in the music scene and seeing how it all works sort of was a big thing for me, and also moving to New York was a big thing that impacted me musically, I guess.
So what's the story behind the name Cutworms?
Cutworms, I took that from a proverb by William Blake, from his Proverbs of Hell, which is in a book called, I should remember the book name right now, but I'm not remembering it. The Marriage of Heaven and Hell, that's it. And it's, the line is, the cutworm forgives the plow. So, I don't know, I just liked that, the destruction of one thing becoming two new things. And yeah, I tried to come up with a name for a long time, and that was the only one that I could say out loud without feeling dumb. So it stuck.
Tell me a bit about your debut EP, Alien Sunset, that just came out.
That one, those songs were recorded at at home in my apartment in Chicago and then in New York on my 8-track recorder, all layered and instrumented by myself, sort of as a process of learning how to record and write. And for the full-length record, which is going to come out, there's going to be a few of the songs, same songs, but for the EP I wanted to give the demos some life and let them exist somewhere instead of just deleting them off of Bandcamp, which is where they were.
Who would you most like to collaborate with and why?
Who would I most like to collaborate with? I don't know. It'd be cool if, you know, just if maybe someone like, if Phil Spector wasn't in prison, and maybe him.
What are some issues that you want to address through your music?
I guess I just try to, I don't really think about it in those terms when I'm writing or anything, but I guess I just hope to make something people connect with and can feel a camaraderie of not very good with words. not very good at talking. But I don't know. I'm not trying to like address social issues in necessarily in songs, but I think anybody who writes songs now or at any time, like anything that's going on affects it and comes through whether you want to or not, or whether you plan to or not. So there's probably some of that in there.
What are your interests and passions outside of music?
I like visual art. My girlfriend's a visual artist, and I do illustration and stuff. That's what I went to school for, so I'm interested in that stuff. That and reading books, watching good shows on TV.
What are your favorite books, film, and music right now?
Books? I'm reading, I've been reading kind of a lot of sci-fi stuff. I read this one that was called The Rim of Morning. It was this guy who only wrote two books, but sort of like cosmic horror sort of tales that are, they were really good. And then TV, my girlfriend and I have been watching a lot of Mad Men. What was the last part of it? Movies?
Music? Movies?
I haven't seen that many movies lately, but music, I mainly just listen to kind of this. I'm always trying to just dig deeper into more obscure stuff, I guess, from 50s, 60s, 70s, and also like big band kind of stuff, earlier jazz. So yeah.
So what's next?
Gonna just keep playing out, I guess, and just keep trying to write more. I've had these songs now for a while, so I've got more that I'm working on. I'm just trying to finish them, and so I can just keep moving forward, I guess.